Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Stealwing 33 Plays Enter the Gungeon. I'm Stealwing 33, and today we're going in as Mad Max Convict because it is time for us to play some more Enter the Gungeon. We had a lot of fun with Ashes of Ariandel, but DLC was actually super short. Like, I had more episodes of the Old Iron King and stuff. But, you know, that's fine. It comes and goes. Plan on doing some PvP action with that at some point, but right now I'm feeling pretty good playing a little bit of Gungeon. I gotta figure out a game that I'm gonna use to fill up the Dark Souls time slot now that Dark Souls 2 is over-ish. I have like two bosses left to kill. Well, I guess one boss left to kill. If you count Vendrick, I've got two bosses left to kill. We'll get to that eventually. That point's not necessarily right now, but we'll get to it. But for now, you know, we'll boot up some Gungeon while I'm trying to figure out what it is that I want to play. I haven't really decided yet. I'm not really the kind of channel that's good for playing games like Civilization and stuff. I'm also too broke to buy Civ right now because I need to be able to feed myself. So that might have to wait till next month if I'm going to do it at all. The M1's really good. Like, good enough where buying it for 45 might actually be worth it. But yeah, I haven't decided. I might actually sit down and do the Warhammer Total War series that I've been meaning to do. Not that I don't own any of the DLC for any of it, so, like, it's an incomplete experience, but... it's something I've been meaning to do. I might also try to do Battlefleet Gothic. That might be fun. I've got a couple ideas of stuff that I can do. That I just haven't gotten around to doing yet. Oh, I cannot believe I got hit there. It's my fault because I was talking and looking at the recording. Yeah, so, I don't know. We'll see. There's stuff I can do. I can play Vermintide. I could do... There's stuff I can do. Then get my buddies together. I might also try to do a League of Legends series, which I haven't done any League of Legends content in quite a long time, to the point where some of the people that are on this channel have never seen any of my League of Legends content. Because that shit's old. Like, old. But we'll see. We'll get around to it. There's lots to do, many things. I could also try to get Tony to come back and play Overwatch with me and stuff. And you know, I've got ideas. I got plans. Ow. What do we got? Gundrama to strain. Nice. All enemies are weaker. Yes, if I remember correctly, this just reduces enemy health. Super good item, actually. Super duper good. One of the best items in the game, from what I understand. Because it makes it so that there's a lot of guns that are just better because of this. Well, they're better longer, rather. But it also just makes it so that there's tons of guns that, like, straight up just are... Like I said, better for longer, but there are rooms that are just gonna go faster. I'll get hit less. It's gonna be great. These bullet kinner only taking two bullets from my sidearm to kill. They're fucking great. Fucking great as hell. Gonna learn today. There we go. Ba-ba-ba. There we go. Not so bad. We're hanging in there. I'm looking for the other chest, because, Black Chest Floor 1 with Gundrama Strains putting us into a pretty decent position, and I'm hoping that we'll get a pretty decent gun. The Pox Cannon is pretty good. I also want to buy the M1, but I also kind of want to buy this key. Let's buy the key. I feel like the key's the safer bet. I really want the M1 because it's one of my favorite guns, but I feel like since we got the Pox Cannon, I'm not feeling the urge to buy the M1 anymore. If we'd gotten something bad, I probably would have bought the M1, to be honest. But I don't know. We'll see. Ow, son of a bitch. Okay, that's annoying. I feel like an idiot already. That's alright. Well, it's okay. It's okay. We'll get through this. Hopefully. I mean, we're definitely not gonna die, but I'm pissed that I'm not gonna get my mastery bullet. I feel like I should. I feel like it's bullshit that I didn't, but, you know, that's fine. It's my fault. I, like, walked straight into that bullet like a goddamn idiot. But, you know, it happens. Jar of Bees. Jar of Bees is better than the Molotov, I think. The Molotov isn't... So the Molotov doesn't affect, like, four or five bosses, but the Jar of Bees affects everybody. I think the Molotov does more damage, to be honest. Why did I come in? Get out of here. I think the Molotov does more damage, but the Jar of Bees is effective on more stuff, so... It becomes a matter of, like, what do you prefer to have a weapon that hits hard but sometimes doesn't hit, or do you want something that always hits but sometimes hits a little bit less? So, I don't know. It should be fine. Pox Cannon's real good. Does a shit ton of damage, as you saw against the Trigger Twins there. Even without the Gundromeda Strain giving me bonus damage. Well, not bonus damage. Giving me, you know, the ability to make this shit happen. Having enemies have less HP. Fucking god damn it. Get your shit together, Andre. Feeling a little off today. It's been a couple days since I actually played Gungeon. So I am a little bit rusty comparatively to when I, like, beat the game with Robot and stuff. So I got a little bit of rust. The rust is real. But, it's also to the point where it's like, you know, I should be able to take 2 days off of Gungeon without immediately sucking dong. Like, that's just me being bad. I want to buy the key. Well, I mean, I don't need the key. Let's see what the chests are before I start saying that I need to buy this key or some shit. Ow. Fucker. Alright, I thought I would be able to fire in time, but I was wrong. Whoop. So the Pox Cannon, you're probably noticing it, so it shoots these little t-shirts, right? Little t-shirts, when they hit somebody, they do damage. And they do, like, a non-insignificant amount of damage. And then they poison the target, and then when the target dies, they spew poison all over the place. This is a joke that was created after the crew who made Enter the Gungeon went to PAX one year, and all of them got sick. So they decided that the Pox Cannon, or PAX Cannon, if you wanna, get on with it, was a funny thing. So I agree. I'm inclined to agree. I can see the gun dudes game over there, and I'm kind of inclined to go try to play it, considering we can get a black chest out of it. So for a little bit of money and one key, we can go get a black chest potentially. So let's go do that. I feel like this is a good use of our resources right here. Yep, let's go ahead and do this. I just need to not be bad at the game here. Go. Oh, come off it. Alright, well, we can get a red chest still if I time these shots correctly. How am I gonna get to that guy there? I feel like there's gotta be a way for me to, like... So if it hits the red one, I'm pretty sure that it just explodes. I guess I can reflect it like that. Got it. Alright, cool. Yeah, green chest is not bad. I'm not going to complain about that. We also got the hammer. So yeah, totally worth the key. The hammer is a great gun, actually. it's one of my favorites. We'll probably end up using this for rooms and stuff. Essentially, it's a machine gun that at the end of the clip fires a hammer out, and the hammer does a pretty decent chunk of damage to whatever it hits. Feeling pretty good. It's pretty good. Happy about it. Let's go ahead and pull out the Pox Cannon. The Pox Cannon's really, really good against enemies that I can only really hit once or twice before they, like, teleport or move away. So I'm not gonna sit here and complain about using it. This is probably one of those rare instances where a machine gun type weapon is actually better against bosses than my slower weapon. I talked about this a little bit. Actually, I posted on the subreddit the other day. Some guy was asking for, he was asking a question about, like, you know, tips for new players. And my big tip is, don't be afraid to use your guns, but always make sure that you have a gun that you're saving for the boss fights. The boss fights are the hardest part of the game, right? That's where you're probably gonna die in a boss fight or as the result of a bad boss fight, right? So, like, I'm getting hurt kind of a lot, but, like, generally speaking, I only get hit, like, once or twice per floor. You know, and don't get me wrong, that's with after a lot of practice and sort of knowing my guns and knowing all the things that I can do and blah, blah, blah. But, you know, when you're first starting out, like, the way you're probably gonna die is not the rooms so much. The rooms will suck and they'll hurt you and stuff, but the boss fight, you're likely to get hurt on the boss fight. There's a reason they reward you for not getting hit on the boss fight, right? You're likely to get hit once or twice on the boss by itself. And if you're likely to get once or twice on the floor as well, then, you know, that damage stacks. It starts coming into play over time. Hazmat suit's really good, actually. Hazmat suit protects us from everything, if I'm not mistaken. But I mean, when I say everything, I mean literally everything. I think protects us from fire, poison, electricity, all the damage types that we can get from floor traps and stuff. Which is good. I'm not gonna sit here and tell you that's not good, because that would be a fucking lie. A dirty, dirty, dirty lie. My other suggestion would be to remember to use the, when you hold control, it brings up the gun menu. Use that to switch weapons. Don't like, do the thing I do, where I sort of just, like, don't do that at all. Ow. Well, I rolled the wrong one, because I'm a fucking stupid idiot. Which is upsetting, actually. Because we're not going to get any mastery bullets now, because it's unlikely. I'm not confident in my ability to get one on four, two, and or three and four. The bosses there are kind of hard. And, I'm, like, super confident normally in my ability to get it on floor one and two, but I've really not had a good run of track record against my floor one and two bosses of late. Shaka Cola is really good. Makes you speed up a little bit. Having high speed makes it easier to hard dodge. Makes it easier to position yourself so that you can normal dodge, stuff like that. It's all good stuff. It's all good stuff. I don't really like the face melter very much, to be honest. I know I have it, but I just don't really like it very much. For the sole reason that, like, it's just not that great of a gun. It's, like, passive ability where it, like, makes a second one is pretty good, right? But, like, we're talking the kind of thing where it's up against guns that, like, their passives are it shoots an explosive dart, or it shoots, like, it toxifies people or something, which is great. Like, those are great things. So there's an achievement for killing people in minecarts, which I need to be more aware of, because I do want to try to get, if I can 100% Gungeon as, like, one of the first games that I've ever actually 100%ed. Yes, for the record, not an achievement guy. Don't really like them. I feel like they add a lot of length, artificial length to the game, but they're not fun artificial length, right? Like, you know, I've played a lot of games where, you know, there's, like, PvP and stuff or online play that adds artificial length to the game. But this is the kind of stuff where, you know, it's not fun to have to, like kill a bunch of enemies with a, like, while in a minecart, right? Like, that's not fun. Like, I guess I could, like, do it by just, like, fighting the bad guys here. But, like, I'm really likely to get hit if I'm, like, trying to kill people in a minecart, right? Because, like, I can't really control where I am ever. So then it leads to moments where, like, I'm riding around in a minecart, and then there's a bullet coming my way, but I can't get out of the minecart. We need to kill people in minecarts. I could toss away, like, six or seven rounds to, like, try to do that, but what is this? It's a key. There are two keys on this room, so we will buy one of these keys, and we will open this door so I can see what's on the other side of this. It's Priscilla with the Elder Blank. The Elder Blank's actually, like, super good. So the Elder Blank's an active item that is a blank, so you can just hit spacebar and it blanks. The reason it's good is because, A, you have unlimited blanks at that point, but there are also, it's really easy to recharge a weapon during a boss fight, especially an active item. Like, super duper easy. That's why, like, the Maiden Shield is one of my favorite defensive items in the game. Is because when you get it, you can, like, if I use the hammer on a boss, right? The hammer is a machine gun. So the way guns get recharged is it's based on the shots that you land and then the damage of the shot, right? So, like, if I fire tons of bullets, I'll recharge the weapon very fast. If I fire really heavy bullets, so like a stinger round or some shit, I will also get tons of charge back. Both of those things are great. To make it really easy to, like, recharge, specifically defensive items. You guys, that's how I beat the High Dragon the first time, was I had the shield on the Maiden, and I just sort of laid into him with the while I had the shield up. Or not while I had the shield up, after I used the shield to, like, dodge just waves of his attack. And then the shield would recharge really quickly, because it had a really low recharge rate. Don't get me wrong, I'm not going to sit here and claim that it was all the fact that I had fast weapons, but it was at least partially that. At least partially. I feel like I shouldn't be immune to the poison globulons, by the way. Just saying. I don't want to be that guy, but I feel like I should be. The face melter is another gun that's actually, now that I'm thinking about it, could be used to recharge a weapon really fast if you really wanted to do so. It's a pretty decent weapon. Decent's a hard word, right? So decent implies that, like, I enjoy using it, and I don't. The face melter is very hard to aim for, like, maximum effect. And there's a bunch of other smaller foibles with it, right? The biggest one for me being that it's only good once you reload it once. So you have to waste it. You have to burn ammo to, like, make it good. And I don't really like the idea of having to, like, don't get... Okay, so that sounds stupid. Any gun, you have to burn ammo to make it good, right? But, like, with the face melter in particular, you have to at least shoot one shot that's not great to make it a gun that's, like, actually pretty good. And then you have to try to, like, cross-aim with, like, the weapon, essentially. And that's kind of hard to do while you're also dodging and trying not to get hit by stuff. So, like, it's a lot of information to try to, like, process all at once. While you're also, didn't know there was a blank or a chest here. I just blanked on accident. Oh, but it had the heroin in it, so I'm super glad that I did that. What up, boy? We heroin now. This gun's really, really good. It's probably the best to second best gun in the game. Probably second best, I'm gonna say, because the Mega Hand is the best gun in the game. The problem with this gun is it has two charge stages instead of one charge stage. The Mega Hand does the same amount as the Heroine, damage-wise, but it only requires one stage of charging to do. And I think it has the same clip size and stuff like that. Clip and ammo size. But you can see the Heroine does a shit ton of damage. Super good against rooms. It's not so great against bosses, literally because the charge rate's kind of bonkers, but that's also the kind of thing that you can work around that, is what I mean to say. But the heroin's really good. Am I gonna use it against rooms? Probably not. The sponge is garbage. It's passive, so I will take it, but the sponge is not something I'm happy to see right now. Let's see what boss we have. Let's go in with the heroin. We have a series of very, very, very good guns, by the way. The heroine, chief among them right now, for me at least, but, try not to get jammed up in a corner by, Cannonball Rog. Feels like a bad idea. As you can see, we're already, like, a quarter of the way through Cannonball Rog, and I fired 6 shots, maybe. I think it might be only 3, to be honest. 3 or 4, actually. But, yeah, this gun does a shit ton of damage. It's real good. It actually might be less efficient than the hammer, to be honest, or the pox cannon. Just because, like, the pox cannon does do that fat dot damage. I'll definitely use the heroin on rooms, but I don't... It might not be a good boss killer just because of the charge. The charge rate on it's a little nutso. It just takes... The double staging is slow, and it just isn't great. I'm glad that the Cannonball Rock has decided to not do its invisibility attack at all. that's real good. Real, real good. Yeah, we have a ton of, like, really, really good guns, and we just got the Galactic Medal of Courage. That increases all of our damage by a lot. This is a really lucky run. This will be a good run. I'm not gonna jinx it by saying we're gonna make it down to the Lich fight or anything, but if we keep getting this lucky, we've gotten real lucky so far. We're out of keys, though, because we had to open up lots of chests on this floor, which isn't great, but, you know, it's also the kind of thing that, I don't think it's that big of a deal, to be honest. Get out of here. Yeah, as you can see, the heroine, real good. Real good. This is a gun based on Samus Aran's weapon from the, Brain, work with me here. Metroid series, there we go, that's the one I'm thinking of. Metroid PCS. This gun does a shit ton of damage. It's real, real good. It one-shots almost every enemy, but that also might be because we also have Galactic Metal Valor and Gundrama to strain at the same time. Like, I'm... Four sidearm bullets to kill literally anything that we have, we set our mind to, is pretty good. We're pretty strong right now. I'm feeling both fat and sassy right now. Oh, there we go. All right, yeah, we're doing great. Like real great. This is not a good gun for this room. The sawed-off actually is a fairly decent gun for this room. Just because of the speed that I can fire it. Ow. Fox cannon, get away from me, please. There we go. Alright. Yeah, the heroine's only really good if you have slow-moving targets. Slow-moving, high-HP targets, heroine's one of the best guns in the game. Like I said, probably second best. I do like the Mega Hand significantly more than I like the Heroine, to be honest. Which is good. I mean, it's good that there's guns that are better than the Heroine, because otherwise, like, we'd be having the best gun in the game, and, you know, like, that kind of feels, not disingenuous, but a little bad. So this is what the face melter does. So it leaves that little amp behind, right? And so you have to, like, if you want to use it to maximum effect, right? Now, granted, this is if you want to, like, min-max the shit out of your guns, which you should do. Shell tan the ammo mental. Do I need ammo for stuff? Yeah, deal with filter. We get a little bit of curse, but we get full ammo. It's not a bad exchange rate. There are probably better times. Like, I probably should say that for after the floor was over, so that way I could get full ammo on all of my guns after I've used all of them for various things over the course of the floor. But that's alright. Using the clob? Ugh. Alright. Like, this isn't gonna be too bad. But I'm not allowed to use my active item, by the way, if you're wondering. No, you're not allowed to use your active item when he says you have to do it with only the clob. Unless it's defensive. I think you just can't kill anything with anything but the clob on this room, and that's how this challenge works. The clob is terrible, as you can tell. The only redeeming quality about the clob is that if you have a passive, it is one of the best weapons to have a passive with. Ancient Hero's Bandana! Oh, fuck me. Yeah, we should have saved the Shell Tan thing, because we could have gotten... We could have gotten all of that ammo, but that's alright. Ancient Hero's Bandana gives us 4 times ammo on all of our weapons. I don't know if it's what we have currently equipped with it when we get it, or if it's just in general. But, yeah, that's one of those items that I'm actually... it's the only item in the game that would have made me pissed about using that Shell Tan altar too early. Fuck, yeah, that would have been really good. Ah, damn it, I fucked that up real bad, didn't I? Just had to be fucking Ancient Hero's Bandana. It's a great item. Like demonstrably one of the greatest items in the game. Because it just gives you so much fucking ammo. Now would be a good time to get Metronome, actually. If we could just get Metronome for, like we used to back, like... I don't know, like a month ago, where we were getting it, like, every other run for some reason. Get out of here. Please die. Come inside. Oh, I don't have any keys. That's right. Excuse me. Are there any hidden rooms in here? No? Okay. So I did look up... Well, after some people were very mean to me on the subreddit about it, I did find out how to look at the... how to figure out where the secret rooms are, right? So the secret room only ever wants to be adjacent to one room. It has a tendency to be attached to specialty rooms. So rooms with chests, rooms with a shop, rooms with... shopkeepers, special, like the ending, the last, like the final fucking elevator room, stuff like that, right? So it wants to be attached to one of those rooms, right? So there's like a checklist. Right? If those rooms are all randomly generated in such a manner like this, where they can't be, it has a tendency to try to be attached to random rooms, right? But it has to be a room. It doesn't like to be outside of the bounding box, right? So if we zoom out here, and I were to draw a box around the outmost rooms of this floor, right? I gotta hold shit tab, apparently. So if I draw a bounding box, right, outside of this room right here, right? The secret rooms don't want to spawn outside of that bounding box, right? So they don't. Generally speaking, they don't. So you can try to find them that way. It's a little bit more taxing to do it like that. I pretty much just check the chest rooms, and then I check the shop. And you cannot shoot in the shop, by the way. Don't forget that. You cannot shoot in the shop. We're also going to get rid of the sawed off here, by the way. But sell that to you. Cool. Do we have anything else we want to sell? I don't really like the face melter. I want nanomachines, by the way, if you're wondering why I'm selling stuff. I really, really want nanomachines. Nanomachines is really good. It's like one of, if not the best, like, defensive health gaining item in the game. Like, yeah, each piece of the Gun Knight armor is pretty good, but, like, it's it's to the level where you're, like, you know, you're left kind of curious about, like, how much ammo am I gonna get, or, you know, it's, the nanomachines is guaranteed to heal you, right? The Gun Knight armor, like, you get one per floor. If you get two pieces of Gun Knight armor, like, you're probably better off than if you had nanomachines. But if you have one piece of Gun Knight armor, I think nanomachines is better. Since I've only ever really had one piece of Gun Knight armor at any given time, I feel like that's probably in one of those things that is good to note. I will say that the face melter is super good against kill pillars, by the way, if you're wondering. Super duper good against kill pillars. And the reasoning there is that, for my submission, the reasoning is that the kill pillars are almost always in a pattern where hitting two of them is a good idea. So, you know, we got that going for us. We got the Roop and Dine prototype, number one. We always get this item for some reason. Like always. I don't really like the Rubandine prototype, for the record. I think it's kind of a garbage item, but, you know, it's good for checking secret rooms, I'll give it that much. Let's check the shop. Probably won't have one, I don't think. Maybe? No, I don't think it will. You can check here, I guess. Let's poke around. We got the ammo, and we got the time. And if it has, like, a little bit of extra money in it or something, it might be worth it, because then I could probably try to buy nanomachines or something. That would be nice. And we could check it with the Rubandine prototype, like, almost immediately. It does not take very long for me to check these rooms with the Rubandine prototype. And we have tons of ammo, so, you know, we got that going for us. I don't think it can be attached to those rooms, to be honest. Well, I'm not seeing it so far. Could be in the King room. Sorry, King man. I promise I wasn't trying to shoot you. Happy accident. Right, well, let's shoot this chest apart then. Just stealth, okay. I don't know, we'll blank the shop before we leave, because we have the extra blank. It was not in here. Okay. Well, let's go. It sucks. I don't want to leave nanomachines behind, but, you know, that's the breaks. Actually, hold on a minute. What else was in the shop before I leave? Before I leave and feel like an asshole, the Moonraker and Tabletech money. Tabletech money, actually, probably. Nah. Let's just save our money. We're going down to 4 or 5. We're going to be able to forge, but there's normally good passives and stuff in the forge for, like, 100 plus money, which, frankly, you know, is the kind of thing that there are things to keep track of. Things to note. I don't actually know the origin of the Rubandine prototype. I'm pretty sure it has something to do with the scientific method, or the scientific theory of, like, bouncing objects losing force, and trying to, like, make it so that they don't lose force anymore, or something like that. Because it's just based on, like, the way the gun works, I guess, is why I'm guessing that's how this, what this thing's based on. But I don't actually know anything about Rubandine. I know that they're famous scientists, because I knew those names before I saw this gun. But I am unfamiliar with their work or anything of that nature. Let's go ahead and grab heroin shots. The heroin's just too good to not have it for ammo for. It's the kind of gun that when I get down to bullet hell, it will still one-shot people, which is why I want it to have more ammo. Because being able to one-shot people on bullet hell will be fantastic. Because it will just breeze through the rooms. If I could get the metronome, it's the kind of gun... If we can get the metronome, it's the kind of weapon that will cause me to win the video game by itself. Just based on, like, the fact that we have so much ammo for it, and we're in such a good position. Pox cannon the shit out of that guy, I guess, for a hot minute here. Oh, come off it. Ah, that guy's got a key, and it unlocks my death. Oh, come on. Hit the bullet kid. There we go. Got him. Alright. Easy peasy. I hate that room. Most annoying fucking room. Shadow bullets. Shadow bullets. I want shadow bullets. We're gonna get shadow bullets. Because that will make several of our weapons too good. Potion of lead skin's also really good because it's a defensive item. It makes you indestructible temporarily. I think you move a lot slower too. Monster blood, not so great. When you get hurt, you spew poison everywhere. We already have the ability to spew poison everywhere. I do not feel the need to acquire more of the ability to spew poison everywhere. I'm good on poison for right now. Don't get me wrong, I'm not actually nervous about it because I do, in fact, have the ability to be immune to poison, which is great. Happy about that. You know, it's the kind of thing that if I could, I wouldn't take that even if I wouldn't take the poison immunity or the poison spewing ability even if I didn't already have tons of ability to produce poison naturally, right? Pox cannon by itself produces more poison than 90% of the items in the game. I feel literally no need to get more poison. The nice part about the pox cannons, you can also shoot it around corners because of, like, the way that the gun's held. Can't get hit by the exploding bulletkin! God damn it. I'm a little grumpy about that, to be honest. There's Beyonce. There we go. The sponge is doing its job. The sponge actually makes it so that I cannot use bug boots, by the way, if you're wondering. Because bug boots, the poison from bug boots is immediately stopped up by the sponge. which is hilarious from a personal standpoint. Really wish I had... I need some keys. There's no keys on the shop, so I'm okay buying shadow bullets right now, to be honest. I would really like to get some keys, so that way I can open up the last couple chests here. It grumps me out a little bit that I cannot, but that's okay. This life is sweet. Day's cool. Day to offbeats. I'm really pissed off that I fucked up that shell pan fight thing. Where I used it too early. That's RNG for you, baby. You do one thing and you fuck it all up. And then your YouTube commenters are making fun of you. And they're like, oh, this nerd, he used the Sheltan altar too early. How dare he not be able to see the fucking future? Well, I'm sorry. My bad. That's not true. No one actually makes fun of me. That would require people to comment on my videos. I've got a good humor about it. No, I'm not actually upset about the fact that no one comments. I'm small. I've only been doing this legitimately for about a year. And this shit takes time. Like, I also don't play a lot of, like, modern games, which is also a problem because that's what people are normally looking for. Even if they gotta play something, like, really obscure and build a following that way, or you need to, like, play something that people are, like, actively looking for. So, like, I should be playing, like, Battlefield 1 right now, right? I can't record my PlayStation 4 because I do not have the equipment to do so. I do own a small HD PBR2, which is not a bad thing. The problem is that it's kind of a huge pain in the ass to set up, and I'm pretty sure that it doesn't work on my PlayStation 4. Unless they finally got rid of that thing that makes it so that you can't HD hijack with the PlayStation. Because that was how, when it came out, there was like a thing in place that prevented you from HD hijacking. Or HP hijacking, rather. HD PBR hijacking. Which sucked, but, you know. But yeah, that's what stopped me from doing it in the first place. Because I like my PlayStation. It's a good system. I like to play games on it. I own like Grand Theft Auto and stuff on it, which would be fun to play for the channel. Just because you guys would be able to see me play a game that I'm not good at all, which I know at least some of you like to watch. And it would be more variety. It's very different than the other kinds of games that I play, generally speaking. I don't normally play shooters, mostly because like I'm okay. I fell like right the hell off there. Alright. Just walked right off the ledge. Fucking rip me. Rip me. It can't be attached to Goopton. I feel like it has to be attached to this room, but I also don't care enough to go look, so we're not gonna. We are gonna pull out the... We're gonna use the face melter during phase one, I think. And then we're gonna use the hammer and stuff later. Like, I'm gonna basically use up my face melter because it's really good against the high dragon, because the high dragon's really big, so it's kind of hard to fuck it up, basically, is how I'm gonna justify this one to you guys. He says as he fucks it up, like, really. I need a fast weapon, because I would really like to get this done with here. And I really need to, like, focus on not dying and dodging more stuff here. Alright, there we go. Alright, just keep firing. I mean, it's working out just fine. Now I want the hammer for this part, because the hammer does the most damage over the smallest amount of time, I think, out of all my weapons. The pox cannon might actually do the most damage over the smallest amount of time for all my weapons right now, by the way. I'm just, spitballing here. Oh, the reload speed's so fast. Yeah, like, we'll be able to get through that in two phases with the hammer. The hammer's really good. It's a really, really, really good item. It's one of my favorite weapons in the game, just because of how fast it fires, and it does like a non-insignificant amount of damage. Killing the second phase of the High Dragon fight three clips, essentially, is not bad. We are real beat up here. Let's head on down. Do I have any money? I do have some money. Let's go back to the blacksmith real quick and buy any health that we can, which is one health. All right, that's actually okay. I'm actually okay with that. With the heroine, we should be able to find the lich fight, right? I have no doubts about that. I feel like we're in a good position to at least make it to the lich fight. Killing the lich, I would really like to get more hammer ammo if we can. The hammer's really good against boss fights. The speed and the damage that it does with the reload, it's good, right? It's really, really good. The heroine's definitely going to carry us through at least a semi-decent portion of bullet hell here, by the way, just because of the damage that it does. Again, one-shotting enemies down here is insane. That's the hallmark of an S-class weapon. If it one-shots enemies down on bullet hell, that's S-class. Oh, okay, I see where the thing is now. It's like right here. There we go. Okay. There's one enemy left. Right there. Now he's dead. You die. Yeah, it even one-shots bullet hell enemies, by the way, if you're wondering. Yes, it's that good. You definitely want to try to get the heroin if you can manage it. It's just such a good weapon. all the time on every floor. Even with the slow charge rate, it does so much damage that it's good enough to be my like second favorite weapon in the game, right? Like that's where I'm at with this thing right now. Is it that good? Almost is good enough to one shot those dudes. Okay, okie dokie, ow. I need to get rid of the shamans like really badly here. Particularly that shaman. Fucking jammed, fucking asshole red shaman here. See, as you can see, the second I wasn't able to, like, one-shot a room, like, everything went to hell for me. Ooh, the Shadow Bullet. That's why Shadow Bullets are good, by the way, is because sometimes you'll just get two bullets, and, like, that's, like, demonstrably one of the best items in the game, especially when you're rolling with the Heroine as, like, your primary weapon, because that double charge shot's so good. Get out of my fucking face. Out of my face and go to hell. If we had ghost bullets, the Heroine would be, I think it would be unstoppable. We'd be unfucking stoppable. Because I could kill multiple enemies with this thing then, and that would be fucking nuts. Because the bullet would just pass through them, like, as if they weren't even there. Let's fire with the Rubandine prototype. We really gotta get clear out some of this. These particular Blobulons are a nightmare because they don't respond like other enemies. They sort of just like die after a while. Like, and I know that that's not like an accurate way to describe what happens to them, but that's sort of what happens. Is they sort of just, they're kind of an asshole and then they die. Like, God, those fucking devil dudes fire so quickly. Anytime there's an enemy with bouncing bullets, I immediately, like, my brain goes immediately to shit when the second they start firing at me. There we go. Hey, health. Oh, thank God. I didn't mean to destroy that chest, but it exploded for some reason, and I'm not really sure why. I should not have come in here with the hammer. The hammer does not have enough ammo left for me to be fucking around with it. Really need it for the lich fight here. Well, that's not great. I've been glossing over it, but we also have like a series of like other ridiculously good weapons. The hammer, the mine cutter is really, really good. Like really good. So its two phases are different. So the solid beam phase does more damage than the tri-beam phase. But the tri-beam phase pierces, it's a really, really, really good gun. Not one of the best, because it's still slow, but it has an uncapped fire rate, which makes it almost good enough, right? Get out of here. Please die. Fucking jammed enemies. Oh! Oh, thank God, that guy almost killed me. Luckily, I've got the reaction speed of an agile cat! That's not true, I actually have, like, really terrible reaction speed for a video gamer. It's, like, better than a normal person, but it's pretty garbo for a gamer. There we go! Alright. We're hanging in there. We've got 1 HP left. I'm not gonna lie, is a little scary. Okay, here we go. Ruben, let's do this. We needed a faster weapon, so we got a faster weapon. Rubandine gun's good, alright? It's just not good in comparison to, like, 6 of our other weapons, which is a quality problem to have, is when you have, like, a good gun that you can't use because your other guns are just better. That should be a meme. I should make a meme. let's focus up here. I want to get more HP if I can. That's goal numero uno, is get more HP. Because I wanted to avoid that. I can't believe you tossed that runaway. God, that was a really good run. I'm a little pissed off that we did at least make it to the Lich fight. We just spent too long on bullet hell, is what it boiled down to. And I didn't get the mastery bullets on those first two easy boss fights. Yeah, with that, thank you all so much for watching. If you guys like what you saw, let me know. If you guys want to see more, don't forget to subscribe to keep up to date on when I post more videos. And if you really like what you saw, leave a like. It helps the channel grow, helps me out a great deal. But of course, with that, thank you all so much for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!